It is the year 1306. Robert Bruce, Earl of Carrick, has travelled to Scone to be crowned King of Scotland by Isabel, the Countess of Buchan. Bishop William Lamberton of St Andrews will oversee this, the coronation of Scotland's warrior king.
Freedom is a noble thing. Freedom gives man choice. Freedom all solace to man gives. He lives at ease, wha freely lives. A noble heart may have no ease, and nothing may him please, for should freedom fail and choice be lost, they shall be yearned for above all. For them who have always lived in liberty should still know that freedom is still the prize, more than all the gold in all the world. The true riches in life are family, kinship, and love. You hold in your hands without fail honor, reputation, and riches. Freedom, wealth, and happiness shall be yours if you can carry yourselves as men. But if you should allow cowardice and wickedness to enter into your hearts, then you will surely live in chains and slavery. What would be a traitor made? What would fill a coward's grave? What seem base as be a slave? Let him turn and flee. But as you long to be free, so you have gathered with us here on this great day. So it is needful that you be bold, strong, and without fear. If you can behave in this way, then you shall know victory, and send the tyrant inward to think again.
Let Scotland's warcraft be this: foot soldiers, mountains, and marshy ground. Let her woods, her bow and spear serve like barricades. Let menace lurk in her narrow places among her warrior bands. And let her plains so burn with fire that enemies flee away, crying out in the night. Let her men be on their guard, and let her enemies in confusion flee from hunger's sword. Surely this will be so, as we are guided by Robert, our King and Lord.
I ask that you follow my determination to fight. For everything is up to you. But all get ready for battle. For fear of death, we shall not fail, nor shall any effort be refused till we have made our country free. From all over the land you have come to me, fired with the spirit of independence, knowing that what you do, you do not as bondsmen in service to some feudal lord, but as free men, marching and dying for your own sakes, your homes, your families, your nation. The common men of Scotland care not for lands nor titles once held by my kinsmen. I was an outlaw after that. The common men of Scotland follow Robert Bruce because they choose to do so. Edward's men fight well, but they take up arms upon instruction to fight for a prize most craved by their master. We are not soldiers, yet we fight for a prize far greater than any crown or pretty bauble that Edward might dream of. We fight for freedom!
War for Scotland's king and law. Freedom's sword will strongly draw. Free man stand or free man fall, let him on with me. By oppression's woes and pains, by our sons in servile chains, we will drain our dearest veins, but they shall be free. Lay the proud usurpers low, tyrants fall in every foe, liberties in every blow, let us do or die.
You will place your right hand upon your heart and repeat after me, we the people of Scotland,
we the people of Scotland,
do declare this day,
do declare this day,
our allegiance to King Robert the Bruce,
our allegiance to King Robert the Bruce,
and do further swear to follow him,
and do further swear to follow him,
wherever he may lead us,
wherever he may lead us,
that our land of Scotland,
that our land of Scotland,
shall forever be free from oppression,
shall forever be free from oppression.
Three cheers for King Robert the Bruce! Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
From countless evils, we shall be set free, thanks to the tireless efforts of our King, Prince, and Lord, the Lord Robert. But if he should give up what he has begun, and shall make us and our kingdom subject to the King of England and the English, then we shall strive to drive him out as an enemy of our people and a subverter of his rights and ours, and make some other man who is well able to defend us our king.
And our William!
For so long as but 100 of us shall remain alive, never will we under any condition be brought under English rule, for it is not riches, it is not glory, neither is it honour for which we fight and contend, but it is for freedom, for that alone which no honest man gives up, but with life itself.
Robert Bruce was king for 23 years, during which Scotland and England finally made peace.